Okay, so we're looking at a video to finish off the trig for the 11 apps course, and we're looking at three things. We're looking at the sine rule, the cosine rule, and area of a triangle, and with area of a triangle, we're looking at the trig rule and Heron's formula. So just a reminder, with non-right angle triangles, we have vertices A, B, and C, and the sides are labeled from the vertices. So if that's A, then that's little a. If that's B, then that's little b. So you have to know how to label the sides, little a, little b, little c, from the vertices. Just remember that part of it. Okay, so the sine rule, there's two different rules, but they're the same rule, obviously. One has the side on top, so you use that when you have to find a side, and the other one has the angle on top if you're trying to look for an angle. So there's two examples, one for each, and have a go when you're ready, and come back. Okay, so we're looking for x, so we're looking for the side, so it's going to be x over sine 61 equals 7.2 over sine 48, and then we just cross multiply that across the other side, times sine 61 divided by sine 48, and now you just have to use your calculator. Get my calculator turned on. 7.2 times sine 61 divided by sine 48, and I didn't say how many decimal places, so it's 8.47, and there's no units, so if you don't have units, you just put U, but otherwise if there's centimetres, you put centimetres. Okay, next one, we've got an angle missing opposite that side, so we put sine theta over 6.3 equals sine 81 over 9.6, so you cross multiply again. Sine theta equals 6.3 times sine 81 over 9.6, and theta will be sine minus 1 of that number. So you don't need to tell me what that number is, just need to do sine minus 1 of it. So let's go clear, shift, sine, open bracket. So you should put this in brackets if you're going to do it in one step. Otherwise, you can get a decimal answer here and put it in later, but I'm going to do it in one step. 6.3 times sine 81 divided by 9.6, close, don't forget to close the bracket, equals, and then let's say nearest minute, so it's 40 degrees and 24 minutes. So just be ready. So you can do your decimal here, but I'll do it in one step. Okay, come across when you're ready. Okay, so we're looking at the cosine rule now, and there's two forms, one when you're trying to find a side and one when you're trying to find an angle. Okay, so it just depends on what you're trying to do. And the big mistake that people make with the side is at the end, they forget to square root at the end. Okay, it's a big mistake. Okay, so pause the tape, and when you're ready, come back live. Okay, so we've got an angle and a side opposite. So that's our A and that's our little a, and the other side's a B and C, and it doesn't matter which one is which. So we've got a squared equals 7.5, 6.1 minus 2 times 7.5 times 6.1 times cos, it's the cos rule, 43. So let's see what that equals, 7.5 squared plus 6.1 squared minus 2 times 7.5 times 6.1. times cos 43 equals, so that number's 26.54. So A equals the square root of that number. So square root answer equals, so the answer is 5.15, and this time we do have units. So this, just an example, like if you forget the square root, the answer is not 26, because you can't have a triangle with 7 and 6 and suddenly have another side with 26. Okay, so this next one, and I forgot to put an angle in. Oh, how silly. So let's say it's that one. Couldn't do that question, that was bad of me. Okay, so finding theta. So that's the angle, so that's A, and that's little a. So cos theta equals B squared plus A squared plus B squared plus C squared minus A squared over 2 times 7.2 and 4.1, and so theta will be cos. cos minus 1 of that number. So I'll do it in one step. So shift cos open bracket. And I'll do another bracket. 7.2 squared plus 4.1 squared minus 5.6 squared. Close bracket divided by open bracket 2 times 7.2 times 4.1 close bracket equals, and then degrees minutes seconds. So I got 50 degrees, and there's 49 minutes, and there was 53 seconds, so it's going to be 50 degrees and 50 minutes. Okay, come across when you're ready. Okay, so we've got two triangle formulas. One is when you have two sides and the angle included, so you use that form. And this one here, you don't have any angles, and you can just use this form called Heron's. And this S is called the semi-perimeter, which is just A plus B plus C over 2. Okay, so when you're ready, come back. I'll just make sure yeah, all the numbers are there. So find the area, find the area. Okay, pause, and when you're ready, come back. Okay, so area. So there's three numbers here, and this is the number that we don't use. Okay, we're going to use half equals a half times 5.8 times 6.1 times sine 32. And that's all we have to do. 0.5 times 5.8 times 6.1 times sine 32. And that gives us 9.37 units of centimeters, and it's an area, so it's a square unit. Okay, that's it. Okay, next one, you have to find S. So S equals 3 plus 6 plus 5 over 2, so 9, 14. So S is 7. So we've got 7 minus 3, 7 minus 6, 7 minus 5. So there are numbers. So area equals the square root of S times 3 times 1 times 2, 21, so the square root of 42, square root of 42 equals 6.48, units are centimeters squared. Okay, so finish that off, come across when you're ready. Okay, so we've got some mixed examples, so I'm not going to tell you which rule to use. And we've got three pages to go. Okay, so have a go when you're ready. Okay, so the first thing you have to do is obviously draw the diagram. Make sure that's right. So ship sails on a bearing of, okay, so north, east, south. So the ship sails on a bearing of north 10 east. So that answers 10 degrees. So now the ship's there for 30 kilometres. So there we're at the there. And then we've got a new cross, and then sails on a bearing of south 40 east. So south 40 east, that's down that way. And that answer, well, it's not 30, that's 40. So there's the 40 degrees east. So the ship is somewhere there, and it sails for 20 kilometres. So that's our diagram. How far and the bearing from the starting spot? So what we're trying to do is find that distance, and the bearing will be whatever that angle is. So we need to find this number there. So the first thing we need to do is we need to have an angle opposite the side. Now, using parallel lines, if that's 10, that's 10, that's a 10. So that means that that angle is 50 degrees. So x squared will be, okay, so we've got an angle opposite, so it's going to be 30 squared plus 20 squared minus 2 times 20 times 30 times cos of 50 degrees. So just do that in the calculator, 30 squared plus 20 squared minus 2 times 20 times 30 times cos of 50 equals, so that's a big number, 528 point something, point 6 whatever, and so x equals the square root of that number, square root answer equals So the answer is 22.99 kilometres, which makes sense. You're going 30, you're going 20. Okay, it doesn't make sense that you're 528 kilometres from home. Okay. So now, just to redraw the triangle, so just make sure you've got what we've got. So we've got a 30 there, a 20 there, and I'm going to make that equal to 23 just to make the numbers a bit easier. And we have to find that angle there, which will then add to 10 degrees, and that'll be our bearing. Okay, so we're going to use the cos rule again. So cos theta equals 30 squared plus 23 squared minus 20 squared over 2 times 20 times 30. And so theta will be cos minus 1 of that number. So shift cos, open bracket, 30 squared plus 23 squared minus 20 squared, close bracket, divided by open bracket 2 times 30 times 20, close bracket, equals, and then go degrees, minutes, seconds, so that's 30 degrees and 58 minutes, so therefore the ship is 23 kilometres away from start on a bearing of, okay, so we've got 10 degrees plus 30 degrees, so it's north 40 degrees 58 minutes in an easterly direction. Okay, that's a complicated question, but you can be expected to do that. Okay, come across when you're ready. Okay, so next one, a triangle has sides 8, 5 and 7, find the smallest angle. So you have to know that the smallest angle is opposite the smallest side. Okay, so there's 8, 7, 5. So if you're looking for the smallest angle, it must be opposite the smallest side. Biggest angle is opposite the biggest side. So again, this one's going to be a cos question. I should have had to go yourself, but anyway. Cos theta equals 8 squared plus 7 squared minus 5 squared over 2 by 8 by 7. Theta equals cos minus 1, that number. So let's chuck that in. Shift cos bracket 8 squared plus 7 squared minus 5 squared, close bracket, divided by open bracket 2 times 8 times 7, close bracket. Equals, and then degrees, minutes, seconds. So it's 38 degrees and 13 minutes. Okay, it was 12 minutes and 47 seconds, so you have to round that up. Okay, got one page to go, see what it is. Okay, so last one, find the area of the shape below. It's a quadrilateral and you need to break it up into two triangles. So can you have a go at that when you're ready to come back live? Okay, so I'm gonna break the triangle that way. If you break the triangle that way, it's not going to help you, because you're going to break those angles up, and what are they going to be equal to? Who knows? So we've got two shapes, shape one, shape two. So area of shape one equals 1/2 times 4 times 5 times sine 110. Equals, so the first answer is 9.40. Area 2 equals 1/2 times 3.5 times 6 times sine 85. 0.5 times 3.5 times 6 times sine 85. That's pretty small. Try that again. I think I made a mistake. I'm just going to check my calculations. 0.5. 3.5 times 6 times sine 85. Oh yeah, that's a bit better. I had a silly answer. 10.46. So the total area equals 9.4 plus 10.46. So that's equal to 19.86 units of centimeters. And we've got squared. And that's it. Thanks for coming. Bye.